Alright, ladies and gents, we're gonna talk real quick. I'm just gonna say this very quick. Sucrose is now a 5-star character. I'm gonna say it from now. I'm sorry you have to hear this from me, but she is a 5-star character. Let me tell you quickly why, just overgoing some of her talents and whatever it may be. But first, I'm gonna show you guys some of her attributes and stuff like that. This is the current attributes going on. I still don't have her artifacts upgraded, and that should tell you something. So flowers at 6, this crit rate, circlet is at 0, her animal damage bonus is at 0 as well. This is at 16, this is at 20. So this should give you a general idea of how good this character is. Her weapon right now is the sacrificial fragments. This actually is not bad. I have it pretty leveled up, but it's not fully at 90 yet. I'm still working on her. She's the latest character I'm working on, so she's gonna get there eventually. Anyways, moving on. I have her at constellation 2, which means I have the most important constellation, which is this one right here, which means her elemental skill gains one additional charge, which is very nice. And obviously the constellation 2 increases the elemental burst by 2 seconds. I mean, that's not much. This is great. This is also good, but honestly it doesn't really matter, because you'll never use the normal charge attacks at all. And this is also really good, and this is amazing. This is so good, but I don't have it, so it is what it is. Here it is, Sucrose. Oh wait, I didn't show you guys the talent. She's at 166. I literally can't get her more than this. All right, so her talents, the E skill just does damage and does swirl. We're gonna talk about why swirl is really important on her kit. And Q, it has elemental absorption, which is really nice, and has damage over time and additional elemental damage, lasts for a few seconds. I don't like it that it's 80 energy cost, but you can just put energy recharge on her and she'll be very good. Which is what I'm thinking about doing. Anyways, we're moving on. Once Sucrose triggers swirl, the fuse that happened, if it's an electro swirl, if it's a pyro swirl, whatever swirl may be, the matching element is in your party, is going to have their amount of mastery increased by 50, which is kind of crazy. If you do a swirl for, let's say, pyro, pyro is gonna get, anybody who uses pyro is gonna get 50 increased amount of mastery, which is nuts. And this one is just also includes, you know, just more. So if you use your elemental skill or elemental burst and it hits an opponent, all party members except for Sucrose elemental mastery is increased by 20% of Sucrose's elemental her elemental mastery is 374. So yeah, so anybody who doesn't know, 20%, let's say, is around, I don't know, 74-75 of the elemental mastery, which is kind of nuts. Anyways, we move on. That's already like 120 elemental mastery depending on which you're using. Currently, I have 2 pyro units on the team, but I should change Zhao. Alright, so I'm gonna show you guys the Viridescent domain, and I'm just gonna show you guys how her talents and stuff work, and why this is pretty good for certain builds. Alright, let me just show you guys the venti that is Sucrose. Before I even continue on, I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about the sacrificial fragments. If you guys use your E at refinement rank 1, you have a 40% chance to end your own CD. So, if you have another sacrificial fragment, which I do, you can refine it in a way where the percentage is increased and can occur more often. So, if I do this real quick, now I have a 50% chance to like eliminate my cooldown, right? But because I have C1, I have 2 chances at a 50-50 shot to get my CD cooldown eliminated or removed. So let's just try it out real quick. Obviously they're gonna be low level, so I hope they don't die instantly. Okay, we're good. All right, perfect. So I'm gonna just like light them on fire and then cause swirl with the Sucrose, boom, and it should work. If we go to Klee here, her elemental mastery should be improved by a lot, which is 185. But if we go to the artifacts here, it shows that it's only 61. And obviously her weapon does not give elemental mastery either. But yeah, you can see the difference here in damage and stuff like that, whatever it is. But yeah, she's insane. You can see also the sacrificial fragments doing work. So yeah, it's just insane. I'm pretty sure it works for Bennett as well. If we go to Bennett's kit here, he has 125 elemental mastery, but his artifacts only give 0 elemental mastery. He just got 125 elemental mastery. Let's just wait for this to end, and we can see their original elemental mastery amount. All right, as you can see, elemental mastery is 0. Legitimately 0. She gives 124 elemental mastery. And I didn't even fully upgrade the sacrificial fragments. I didn't fully upgrade her artifacts. It's insane. Guys, ladies and gentlemen, that is why Sucrose is a 5-star unit. Now, I'm not only going to mention that, but I'm also going to mention the elemental mastery buff that is coming in the new Genshin update in 1.6. So if you don't have Sucrose built, you're going to have a chance to build Sucrose in the 1.6 Klee banner, which she's going to be in. But yeah, guys, that's gonna be it for today's video. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, subscribe to my channel. Make sure you guys consider liking as well. This is a video for Sucrose, but I'm still building her. So once I fully build her, I'm gonna show you guys a proper showcase with a proper team. I still need to build out my Tartaglia. I still need to build out my Klee and my Bennett as well. So all of them are fully built, it's gonna be quite nice, and I can't wait to show you guys. Anyways, guys, hope you guys did enjoy. See you guys in the next video very soon. Goodbye.